Yes. Guns N' Roses. A band that couldn't handle the worldwide fame and fortune that they built, and whose constant beefs with other bands and whiny antics on and off stage set up the recession of hair metal that Nirvana would later turn into a apocalypse, or rockpocalypse, as I like to call it, in the early 1990s. Whether or not you blame Guns N' Roses for the decline of hair bands in the 1990s, you do have to admit that they were a fantastic swan song for the genre. Guns N' Roses was the last hair metal band to see true mainstream success, and their five albums that they released in the late 80s and early 90s went down in history as some of the best pieces of music ever released. It makes sense as to why, because these guys really were one of the most genre-defining bands of that era. Plus, they made an extra album in 2008 that everyone has kind of forgotten about, but, you know, we'll review that one as well. After 15 years of musical limbo, Guns N' Roses came together to create Chinese Democracy. Not only is the album poorly made and poorly mixed, there's a solid zero re-listenable songs on this record, and I don't have any desire to go back and re-listen to it again. Despite that, this album was a return for Guns N' Roses to the charts in 2008. This album charted fairly high on the album charts, not to mention it had a single, Chinese Democracy, the lead single, that also charted inside of the Billboard Top 40 and peaked at number 34 in 2008. It barely got any mainstream radio play, basically because Guns N' Roses did not meet the musical criteria of the time. None of the covers on this album are really good, except for Since I Don't Have You. And you could really tell that Axl Rose's ongoing PTSD from traumatic childhood experiences and a reckless adulthood behavior was starting to become too much for the public. I'm terribly sorry, but I just kind of have to go out and say it. I don't like Lies. I don't think Lies is a very, very good album. I'm not impressed with it whatsoever. I think it's a sophomore slump. Patience is a good song, but I think that's just because it's kind of too simple to fail, really. And I Used to Love Her has funny lyrics. And other than that, that's all I got. I honestly kind of feel like Guns N' Roses gave up on this whole Use Your Illusion project about 75% of the way in, basically because Civil War and Knocking on Heaven's Door are absolutely knock your pants off fantastic. And that's about it. And just so I can avoid having people ask about it, no, I don't like Estranged. I don't think it's a very good song. I think it was kind of too long for its own good. They kind of made what could have been a four and a half minute song into what was almost, I think, 8 minutes or something like that. And I don't think it was a very good addition to the Use Your Illusion 2, you know, project. If you're watching this video, you are probably already aware, so I'll keep it brief. This is one of the greatest debut albums ever made. There are very few albums that exist where every single track on the record is it. Like, you know that feeling where you can listen to an album straight through and love all of it? There's very few albums out there that possess that quality. Ones that come to mind are Rumors by Fleetwood Mac, Peace of Mind by Iron Maiden, Pyromania by Def Leppard, there's not a lot out there. Use Your Illusion 1 is close. It's very close. Not quite there, but it is respectfully close. It is so good. Almost every song on it just hits in the right spot. It's fantastic. Don't Cry and Coma are some of the most addicting songs I've ever listened to. I can listen to both of those songs probably 20 times in a row and love it probably more than I did before the first time. Live and Let Die is one of the best covers I've ever heard. I think it's better than the Paul McCartney and Wings version. And November Rain. I had to give my own section to November Rain, because November Rain is not only probably the best song on the album, and I feel like a solid amount of people would not totally disagree with that, but it's a masterpiece. It is a top three favorite song of all time for me, personally, and it is by far, in my opinion, the best song Guns N' Roses ever made. I don't know what else I can say about that song and this album. It is almost perfect. It's a 9.9 out of 10, which is better than 99.9% of albums out there. Go listen to it if you haven't already. It is incredible. So, thank you guys for watching. This is it. Only 6 albums. It's kind of a shame that Guns N' Roses never released more, but yeah. So, thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you guys next time.